It looks like a typical cash machine, but there's something about this one that makes it a, how can I say this, a bit different.
This is a Robocoin Bitcoin ATM. It does two-way transactions, meaning you can put cash in and get Bitcoin, or you can take Bitcoin if you want to sell it. You can put that through the machine.
I'm not even sure what a Bitcoin is. Now we have Bitcoin machines. Seems like we've got a lot to learn about this new digital currency.
If you put $10,000 in Bitcoin of January 2013 and sold it less than a year later in November, you would 100% be a millionaire today.
Sounds like there's gold in them there Bitcoins. Ryan Price of Victoria sure hopes so. He and a partner have started BitBrokers. They've brought Vancouver Island its first Bitcoin machine, set it up here at Victoria's Hemp & Company. Vancouver got its first Bitcoin machine last year. There are about 100 Bitcoin machines worldwide. One Bitcoin right now will cost you about $600 Canadian, even though there's no physical coin or paper money.
In a sense, we've been living with digital currency for several years now. I mean, when you look at your bank account, you probably get direct deposit paid to your bank account. You probably don't think there's a stack of dollar bills in that bank with your name on it, right? But you know the funds are available, but they're in digital form. And then you take your debit card, you go pay, that money gets digitally transferred to the retailer from your bank account without any physical cash changing hands. So it's not that strange of a concept if you really consider how we've been living for the last while.
You can access your Bitcoin account through your smartphone or computer. Sounds simple to use, but the history of the Bitcoin is complex and shrouded in mystery. It's been traced to someone named Satoshi Nakamoto,
which is sort of the Japanese equivalent of John Smith or John Doe. It's a very common name in Japanese. And he remained anonymous, but he put out a white paper that introduced and explained the concept of sort of a decentralized online digital currency. He posted on a message board for a while and then faded into the shadows, and we haven't really heard much from the creator since then.
Which brings up questions like, who's regulating the Bitcoin industry? According to my online research, no central authority has any power to control or manipulate the system. I'm confused and suspicious, but I'm also confused and suspicious about our current money system. However, a handful of businesses in Greater Victoria are embracing this new currency, and the list is growing.
Who wouldn't want a Bitcoin machine in their store?
Bill Finley, owner of Hemp & Company, welcomed the idea of having a Bitcoin machine in his store. While he's interested in the Bitcoin concept, he's more interested in making his customers happy.
Possibly once a week we have a Bitcoin transaction. Never had a problem. The service fees for doing it are way lower than they are with credit cards, for instance. We've reached out, as I was hoping, to a clientele that probably only came in here because we did Bitcoin.
It takes the power out of government, it takes the power out of banks, financial institutions, and it puts it back to the people. It's basically peer-to-peer money.
I really like this idea of an alternative currency, but I bet the status quo is not too impressed by it. The ultra-rich, the people who are pretty happy with the way our money system is right now.
It sort of reminds me of that Einstein quote where you know, the more radical an idea is, the more violent the opposition to it. And I would say absolutely banks and governments, they don't really know how to deal with this right now, and they're struggling with it.
We all struggle with new ideas at first, like email and the internet when they appeared in the mid-90s. Now I can't imagine life without them.
Well, every day we see more and more businesses popping up that support Bitcoin. We see more people taking it. Expedia just came online. You can book your vacation in Bitcoin now, just this past week. So
I think you'll be seeing more Bitcoin machines on the island. Probably safe to say you could bet your bottom dollar on it. In Victoria, I'm Dan Kahn.